Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to explain just writing a simple bass line and then adding a number of different modulation and effects to it. So I'm going to come here, I'm going to start with Ableton. I'm just going to arm a track on Ableton. The Jupiter 6 is acting as my controller keyboard at the moment, so I'm going to play it here, but this is actually going to be playing a patch on the Prophet 5. So I'll start by getting a sound that I like, you know. Sure. And just making it raw. So this is just the raw Prophet sound now. And so I'll put a metronome on the Ableton and get the clock running. Come over here, give myself something to play to. And I'm going to arm a channel on Ableton, and then I'm just going to play. And I'm not going to try and do it necessarily right the first time. I'm just play, and then I'll take a segment of something I like afterwards. Coming here, I'm taking this. And so let's say I like that. So we'll come. And now I'm gonna take this sound and I'm gonna send it through some effects. I'm gonna take off the metronome because I don't need it anymore. And so right now we just have the Prophet 5. So I'm going to take this, and I'm going to send an auxiliary send now, and I'm going to take that and I'm going to send it through the Moogerfuger, the MIDI Murph, and that is going to bring that into a new quality. So I'm actually going to take this off of the desk now. It's still going to be going through the channel, and now it's just sending over to here. And so it's going to be going into this MIDI Murph here, and you can see how we're getting level already. From that. And what this is doing is this is already synced to MIDI. And so this is going to be panning through different frequency bandwidths on the sound. And so I'm going to open up the channels on the MIDI Murph and then send it through. And it's quite subtle. It's just basically just taking this and with timing sending it through these. So, you know, I might set this to a certain way that you can hear kind of a more extreme version of this now, of what that's doing. I'm going to still keep a little bit of the original sound in the mix, though. And then what I'm going to do next is I'm going to leave this sound in the desk, but now I'm going to add some ambient sounds around it. And so this now is going to be sent into the reverb, let's say. And so on auxiliary one of my desk, I have the Eventide Oroville, and I'm going to take that and I'm going to send it into the Oroville. Now what that would sound like if the Oroville was just on would be a big swarming black hole effect that we have here on the Oroville, which is here, you know. So we come here and we can go in here and say, okay, you know, maybe we want a different time. It doesn't really matter. A different modulation. I might figure out a more in-depth modulation if I was working on a track. For now, I'm just going to leave it the way it is. So again, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this reverb that we have here, but I'm not actually going to have that assigned to the master outs. I'm going to take that off. I'm going to take this reverb here and send this through a ring modulator, which is going to give a panning effect, which I explained before. And so auxiliary 5 on my desk sends to an input over on my modular synthesizers. Actually, all of these inputs do. There's four of them that send out of the desk, and I have inputs that I can choose to kind of reroute through different aspects, whatever I choose. And so now I'm going to come over here, and I'm going to take this and put it through this frequency shifter. And so what's happened here is this send here is send 5. And so send 5 is going into the audio input of the frequency shifter. This frequency shifter is sending out to the mixing board and then back to the main mixer over here. Now this frequency shifter is going to have an LFO that's going to be sending a triangle wave out of the LFO and into the timing of the modulation speed of the ring modulator, which we have an attenuator on, so we can choose how much that we want that to be. And so when we hear that, this is the sound now of the prophet going through the reverb, and now through the Moogerfugger first, into the reverb, and then through the ring modulator. Now with the cameras, I'm not sure how much you can pick up as far as what's going on with the speakers, but basically you've got the ring modulators going back and forth. You can see it panning back and forth with the levels with the lights actually on the desk. And now on this, we're gonna add a little bit of delays. Now these delays are coming off of auxiliary send, auxiliary 2 send on my desk. And they're coming through and now going into this D5000. And so this, we wanna make sure is the right timing. We come in, it's 124. You can come in and choose what kind of delays you want. You know, let's say we want a big long one. Let's say we want this modulating back and forth a little bit, so we can come in and play with the panning of the delays, the depth, the speed. If we want to have it changing a little bit differently, like I said earlier about not always having it necessarily timed, we can take it out of sync a little bit. And then what's going to happen with that is that now these delays are coming back into the desk, returning, and these are here. So now you're getting a sound that is starting to have obviously a lot of different atmosphere. We could even take this sound out of the mix completely, and just use this as ambient tone, which could color maybe another sound that's going to sit on top of this. But this is just ambient harmonics now. There's lots of options. It just depends on what direction you want to take it. I'm going to put that back in. Something I like to do is I like to put delays, my delays through phasers. So I have a phaser here set up on auxiliary send 3. And this auxiliary send 3 is going to send out into the Korg A1. And so I'll go in and I'll edit my phasers. You know, we've got a really nice slow moving phaser with quite a wide depth. And a little bit of resonance, but maybe not so much that you're actually going to hear a bell sound. And that'll just give a little bit of kind of sparkly movement on the delays from the bass line. And obviously, there's too much reverb going on this for it to be a bass line, you know, so we'll do things to tune it. We'll do things like this by pulling the reverb back, you know, into something that's a little bit more usable. Maybe there's too much delay, so we tone these things back. I had these all up loud so you would understand the effect. But in actual fact, when it comes to a track, you're gonna be drastically tuning back all these delays. So it's essentially, you still get the sound of the bass line, but you just have some little sparkles in the background that keeps everybody interested. So that's basically going to be the setup as far as the bass line. And then next I'll move on to writing some drums.